এই টেকনিক্যাল ব্যাপার আমার জানা নেই, বরং তুমি ফোন করো। ওয়েট, ওকে স্টুডেন্টস, আই হোপ অল আর ওয়েল অ্যান্ড প্লিজ অ্যাটেন্ড দ্য ক্লাস বিকজ দিস ইজ ভেরি ইম্পর্টেন্ট চ্যাপ্টার নট অনলি ফর দিস এক্সামিনেশন বাট অলসো ফর দ্য ফাইনাল এক্সামিনেশন অ্যান্ড ইট ইজ রাদার রাদার মার্কস টেকিং বা গেটিং চ্যাপ্টার মার্কস গেটিং চ্যাপ্টার সো প্লিজ ফলো ইট গভর্নমেন্ট বাজেট দ্য নেম অফ দ্য চ্যাপ্টার ইজ গভর্নমেন্ট বাজেট What do you mean by budget? Each and every country makes budget before starting the financial year. Not only the government, but also even individual clubs, society, before the starting of the financial year, they make budget. That is, budget means the statement of revenue and expenditure of that particular financial year. I hope you know revenue. That is the earning of the government from different sources, and expenditure is the spend of money or capital for the development of the country itself. Now, the budget is announced by the finance minister of the state government, by the finance minister of the central government, stating the income and expenditure of the coming financial year. It is the statement of income and expenditure of that particular financial year. You know that even a person who earns money monthly or weekly, they make budget to meet the expenditure and saving. If it is not done, then he may spend the month's expenditure amount in a particular week. Then he will have to suffer for the rest of the days of the month. Therefore, it is not the system. The system is to make a budget, revenue and expenditure. What the amount he can earn or the country can earn from different sources, and the country may spend that earned money on different fields of the country. Therefore, it is the statement of revenue and expenditure in short. Now, I told you in India, 1st February of the new year, the finance minister declared the budget for the rest of the months, that is the financial year. Now, the budget has two sides. One is fiscal and another is budgetary policy. Now, it can be expressed in another way. That is better. Revenue aspect and expenditure aspect. It would be better. Revenue aspect and expenditure aspect. What I told you, revenue aspect and expenditure aspect. Revenue aspect is the aspect through which the government earns income. How? The government earns income from taxes, number one. Taxes are of two types. That is direct tax and indirect tax. Direct tax and indirect tax. What do you mean by direct tax? The tax which is directly deducted from the income of the incumbent. The tax which is directly deducted from the income of the incumbent is called direct tax. No income earner under this direct tax cannot avoid any tax. Suppose the salary holder cannot avoid to pay taxes because the government has the account in his office. So if you don't pay taxes in every month, then at the end of the year, before the end of the year rather, you have to pay all taxes as per calculation given by the taxpayer or office. If you don't pay, you will receive a letter and have to pay with penalty, fine. Therefore, direct tax is the tax which is paid directly out of the income of the incumbent. And indirect tax, the tax which when the taxpayer and original taxpayer and the tax paid to the government is different. The person who is actually paying the tax, he is not paying the tax directly to the government. For you, another person is paying the tax. Suppose sales tax, excise tax, these taxes are indirect tax. When you purchase a commodity from a shop, you have to pay sales tax. And whom you are paying? You are paying to the seller of that item, and he is receiving. Either he directly then and there, or before the end of the year, he pay that tax to the government. Therefore, the seller is paying the tax to the government, but he is not the actual payer of the tax. You, the buyer, is the actual payer of the tax. So it is indirect tax. You are paying the tax to the government indirectly through the seller. So these are the chief sources of income of the government. And not only that, there are other sources. Road tax. You know, the government construct roads, and for that the cars of different types have to pay taxes, road taxes, and the tax goes to the exchequer of the government. And now you know that these taxes collected from different sources are deposited in the bank account, where? In the reserve bank account of the central government. Now, What are the objectives of government budget? What are the objectives of government budget? Number one, GDP growth. Number two, allocation of resources. Allocation of resources. Number three, provision of public goods. Provision of public goods. Number four, redistribution of income. Number five, balanced economic growth. Balanced economic growth. And there are some other points I will discuss. I'll discuss these five points, then I will write the other points. So GDP growth, what do you mean by GDP? What do you mean by GDP? GDP means gross domestic product. Practically the development of a country mostly depends on the growth of GDP. If GDP does not grow more and more, then the economic development cannot take place. It depends on the production of different sectors, agricultural sectors, industrial sector, service sector, etc., etc. So GDP growth is a crucial point in connection with the objective of government budget. The government takes some steps so that the GDP growth may increase. In order to increase GDP growth, the government takes so many steps, like invest it in the different sectors of the economy. The income of the general people should be enhanced, but they enhance the income of the general people so that the expenditure increases. You know that if the expenditure does not increase, development cannot take place. Development cannot take place. Now, two is allocation of resources. In our country, market value of final goods and services in a financial year. What is your question? Market value of all final goods and services in a financial year will give you the national income? Will give you the national income of a country? GDP. Okay, that is national income is in the form of GDP. Both are same. Therefore we are allocating allocation of resources. What do you mean by allocation of resources? Resources are normally not allocated equally among the citizens. So it is one of the objectives of the government budget is to allocate the resources to among all the people of the country by taking steps through tax. The higher income groups, taxes are imposed on higher income group people. And higher the income, the rate of tax becomes higher and higher. So, this income is redistributed for the benefit of the poorer section of the people. For the benefit of the poorer section of the people. That is, resources are distributed in such a way so that the people who belongs to the lower sector of the people can get benefit and the excess income group or higher income group must pay for it. This is allocation of resources. Is it clear or right here? If not, please write here. Someone is writing. Ato choto. Video is not visible, bolche. Yes, sir, clear. Who is speaking? Jyotirmoy. Very good. So, I think this is clear. Then number three, provision of public goods. In particularly the country like India, Bangladesh, Nepal, the government should come forward to give some advantages to the poor and poorer section of the people. Because their purchasing power is so limited that they are unable to purchase essential commodities at the market rate from the market. In this respect, the government should come forward and the essential commodities can be distributed through government shops, particularly to the poorer section of the people, at a lower and lower price, and sometimes even freely. Now you know that government is helping the poorer people by giving rice, wheat, etc., etc., without any price, freely. Freely they are serving it. It is the function of the government that the people should get the benefit of the government's income. The government should take higher and higher taxes from the higher income group and distribute it to the lower income group. So you know that direct tax, income tax. If the income increases with the increase of income at different slabs, the rate of tax increases. The rate of tax increases, and that in that income, out of that taxes, the government spends for the either for the welfare of the people or for the development of the poorer section of the people. Right? So redistribution of income means to take a part of the income from the higher group of the people of the country and redistribute it among the poorer section of the people so that they can live from hand to mouth. Right? And number five, balanced economic growth. You know, India is a vast country. All parts of the country are not equally developed. Some part of the country is agriculturally developed. Some parts are industrially developed. Some parts are very rural areas. They suffer from the crisis of food grains and the industrial product. It is the function of the government to purchase the commodities, both agricultural and industrial, and redistributed it in the poorer areas of the country, poorer parts of the country, at a government fair price. And sometimes the government does it. And it is one of the objective of the government to make benefit for all the people belongs different sections. Therefore, balanced economic growth means a region may be developed in agriculture, another part may be developed in industry. That is, it is the function of the government to distribute the agricultural products to those states who suffer from food crisis, and the industrial product to distribute these products to those areas, the areas suffers from industrial product. This is the regional balance. One region of the economy may be developed in agriculture for some reason, and another region may be developed in industry. That is, industrial products are cheaply sold there, but the agricultural sector of regions may not enjoy that product easily or at a lower price. It is the government's function to distribute all these products, irrespective of industrial product or agricultural product, throughout the country, removing the state boundaries. Okay, so this is called balanced economic growth. Economic growth, if regional economic growth take place, then it is not healthier one. If one part of your body becomes developed, it is not the sign of growth of your physical structure. Rather, it is injurious for the person concerned. Very like that, if there is unbalanced growth in the country, there is no balance in the economic development, then there must be the differences of regional growth, differences of region, culture, people, and the country will be what? The country will be divided into several parts, unity will be disturbed. So number six. Kotokon time ashe go. Kotokon time ashe? Employment opportunity. Employment opportunity is the another point. Employment opportunity is one of the important factor and one of the important objectives of the government budget, because if most of the people or a part of the people, a regional part of the people becomes unemployed, they becomes the burden of the economy. So the government should take such policy through which generation of employment opportunity can be done. Generation of employment opportunity can be done. Otherwise, if there remain unemployment, the development will not take place, because if they remain unemployment, they will have no purchasing power. In spite of the increase of production, the produced commodities will remain in the market unsold. So demand and supply, if the market economy does not work, market economy means demand and supply does not work, then the good equilibrium point cannot be achieved. Therefore, the employment opportunity should be created by the government so that income of the people may increase. Suppose if a person has income in his hand, money in his hand, he will go to the market and purchase different types of commodities. If those commodities are sold in the market, the factory will run. If the factory runs, the employment opportunity will be created. Therefore, there is a circle through which the economic development can be done. The lower circle to higher circle you may achieve. So this is everything for today. There is 6 points. I will discuss another 3 or 4 points later on. Thank you very much. I hope you are all right.